Greetings from Purgatory. So yesterday, we had a little bit of an issue. A neighbor messaged me around 3:50 in the afternoon to ask me if I knew of any fires nearby. So I quickly popped up watch duty and pulse and didn't see anything. But then she said there was something happening to the south of us. So I walked into the kitchen and looked out the window, and I saw this. Yes, that is our neighbors on fire. It turns out one of them had tried to start a truck with a known fuel leak, and things kinda got out of hand. So then I went back into the house and I called 911 to report the fire and give the address, and we made sure everything was prepared in case we had to bug out. Bags were ready, birds were ready, everything was ready. But soon enough we could hear the engines coming up the hill, and then a spotter plane from Cal Fire arrived, and very soon things got very, very busy. And then we had a first here at the ranch, because Cal Fire decided to use a rodeo ring to drop off a crew of linemen. And as you can see here, they landed in the rodeo ring, and it was very windy. And I do worry, because we have two nest boxes down there that I know have little nestlings. We have tree swallows and western bluebirds, so I do worry about them. But the helicopter dropped off the linemen. Meanwhile, a spotter plane dropped off a line of retardant across the back hillside. And then the linemen disembarked and tromped across our south pasture to get to the neighboring property, where they then set to work stomping on things. The chopper then left as the crew made it over the wall, and it went to pick up water. And then a long series of airdrops of water were dropped onto the fire. As you can see here, a chopper is coming in, and then it releases its load. By this point, the fire had spread, and it was threatening buildings. And in fact, that red building right there in the foreground, it suffered, well, catastrophic damage. And you'll see more images of it later. But again and again, here in slow motion, the chopper came back and dropped more and more water onto the area. There were also linemen up on the hillside in the back, as well as the crew down below on the off the road, and then crews right there within their courtyard area working to battle the blaze. And here's one more shot in super duper uber slow motion. Wait for it, it's worth it. So the chopper was picking up water probably from Lake Cunningham. That's usually what happens. Lake Cunningham is a man-made lake down from us. And fun fact, we're now the SFBBO sponsor for the colony of egrets and herons at Lake Cunningham. I think that's really cool. But as you can see, more water was dropped. And this continued for about an hour, with the chopper coming back and forth and back and forth, dropping water each time. And here's one final shot of a chopper dropping water, plus a fun little pic our neighbor down the way took, which shows the chopper from the viewpoint of our gates, and it really does look like we were on fire. But thankfully, we weren't. About 2 hours after the fire actually started, Cal Fire started to wrap things up, and the chopper came back in and landed in the rodeo ring, which once again made me bite my nails a bit, because I do worry greatly about those nest boxes. And you'll see here in this picture, just as it comes into the rodeo ring, just as it starts to land, over on the far, far right, by that green well tank, there's that little box getting knocked and hammered in the wind. That little thing has about 7 baby tree swallows in it, and I just hope they're doing okay. We'll be checking on them on Thursday, because that's our normal nest box check day, and I'm crossing my fingers that everybody's okay. But anyway, the chopper landed just fine, and then soon enough, the linemen came back across the pasture and got in. At this point, you can see there down in the hill a bunch of service vehicles. You can see smoke rising there from that property. And things were starting to settle finally and to calm down. Now, our road was still closed to any incoming traffic, and it remained that way for several hours afterwards. But as you can see, the crews had things pretty well in hand by this point, and so we were starting to breathe a little easier. With the chopper heading out, The crews remained on site far into the night, with the last truck pulling out around a little after midnight. Things were a little smoky, and we definitely could smell that there had been a fire, but we were very grateful that things had gone as well as they had. You could just see that chopper moving out. There it goes. Now, as for the aftermath, here's some drone footage I shot late last year when we were working on the pit. Here you can see the house, which is over on the right with the red roof, and we think the truck that caught on fire is right there in the center of the frame, that white truck. And then there's a building on the left, a low-slung red building, that they rented out. And then that little plywood structure in between, we're not sure what that was. But that's what the property looked like recently. And this is what it looks like now. As you can see, the main house was spared, but a good portion of the deck on the left, as well as all the retaining wall over on the left side, has been destroyed. And their little building, their plywood building, is completely toast. There's several burned out cars, and then that red rental ADU is just, it's gone. That's where they were dropping the bulk of the water. And for those wondering, and regular readers, this is the same property we've had numerous problems with their livestock getting out and over onto our land. In fact, that area just there over in the upper left, those are the animal pens. And you can read about and watch the other videos detailing all that. And one fun note that came out of all of this, though. And that was 1 week exactly ago. From the fire, we got final written approval on the grading of the pit. Now, regular readers will know that the pit was created back when our house was built. It was a source of constant problems, ponding water, trash. It destabilized the entire hillside, and we had to fight for 6 years for county to allow us to finish filling it. Now, it was created because up there in the upper right here of this shot, that's where the road used to end. And as you see, all of this road that I'm panning across in this drone shot, all of that was built from the contents of the pit. Doc Richards cut, and he used it to make a roadbed to extend the road up there just past the pit to what was formerly the original driveway to our property. And like I said, it was 1 week exactly. So I was thrilled that the pit got used. We had so many trucks, so many emergency vehicles down in the pit using it as a place to basically be organized and get their trucks and get their water lines out. It was absolutely glorious. 1 week exactly. Which is especially satisfying because that road has no turnaround. And one of the arguments we made for being allowed to fill the pit was to create a turnaround for emergency vehicles. So once again, it was absolutely glorious. And while we're not on the best terms with those neighbors, thanks to their errant ways, at least their house did not get completely destroyed. And so there you have it, our second fire here at Purgatory Auto Works and Dinosaur Farm.